Hello. Welcome to Das Karnival. It's a variety show filmed right here in Colombia. What we do here is we expose local artists and let Colombia have a taste of what's going on. Right now, I'm waiting on word from Blacksmith. They're going to be the band tonight. They're supposed to be here right now, but I'm guessing they're having car trouble or something. Hello? Yes. Where are you guys? Okay. Just get here. What? Yeah. Alright, I'll try. Okay. That was Blacksmith. They're running a little late. They're a trio, a little hip-hop rap thing. I guess they play instruments too. But let's see. The studio we're coming from, it's pretty nice, pretty state-of-the-art. We've got cameras in many locations for your viewing pleasure. Camera here, camera here, camera here, and camera. I don't know what that was. But I do know what this is. This is a film that was shot right here in Columbia, Missouri. It's called 10 to 27. It's by local filmmakers, The Ejects. It's part of the 48-hour film contest. And what that is filmmakers compete to see who can make the best film in only 48 hours. You have to write, shoot, edit, direct, present, music, all that, 48 hours. Check it out, 10 to 27.
Hi, yes, I'm calling about a room for rent. My name is M. Marceau. Yes, I'm very interested. Today would be wonderful. Yes, I can be there. All right, I'll see you then. Valentine.
You must be a Marceau.
Yes. The room, is it available now?
Yeah, number 12 just opened up.
The mailboxes are behind you, as you've seen. The laundry's in the basement.
It's really quiet here. Do you have many tenants?
A few.
Hi. Was she okay?
She's perfect.
Oh,
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to startle you.
Oh, if you do that again, I'll scream.
Everything's a mess. It's when I
The reason, the purpose I've done this to you, Miss Marceau, and the others, is not to harm you. I'm on the brink of scientific discovery. Human perfection. And you, M, are my finest masterpiece yet. By removing your striatum nucleus, I have allowed you to be free of the most negative emotions, fear. Now, you are perfect.
And we're back. Ladies and gentlemen, that was incredible. You know what else is incredible? It's your breath, Hugo. I mean, wow. You're like 5 feet away. It's Hugo, ladies and gentlemen. He's our stage boy and a fluffer. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Blacksmith. Why don't we start with you guys introducing yourselves?
I'm Chazelle.
I'm Double A.
I'm Blacksmith.
So it says here, you guys are rappers.
Yeah, we rap.
Well, they sure don't really look like rappers, do they? If you're just tuning in, I just got punched in the head by Blacksmith. I guess they really are rappers. Sorry about that comment, fellas. I hear you're working on a new album.
Yeah, we've got an album coming out in late 2005.
Better go cop that piece.
It's called Fade the Blacksmith.
Know about it.
If you could describe your music in one word or less, what would it be?
Blacksmith.
Isn't that two words? I said one word or less.
No, just one word.
One word.
Dollar sign for the S.
No space.
I know I do some of my finest music listening when I'm riding around in my Buick. Tell me, Blacksmith, what music do you listen to when you ride around in your Buick?
Blacksmith.
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 So, can you tell me which song you'll be performing tonight?
It's a little song called Mopping the Floors with You.
Mopping them floors.
Gotta get them clean.
I used to be the custodian, and it's about the emotions I experienced.
No doubt.
All the hardships. All the love.
Struggle.
Well, it's time for y'all's performance. So I'm going to tune in right here, guys, to the handy dandy little magic radio.
Blacksmith's back, and he's got a new job. He's your janitor man, and he's cooking a mop. Watch your step, and mind your biz. Blacksmith don't like these little kids. So all you children making a mess, you better stay on a permanent recess. And all you teachers don't know what you're in for, you're about to fall in love with a janitor.
Smith is back to say hello again. I used to mow grass, but now I'm a custodian. With my mop in my hand, I walk down the halls, my breath reeking of hard alcohol. When you disrespect my property, you disrespect me. It hurts my feelings when you leave piss on the seat. You did a number one, then you did a number two. You didn't flush a toilet, now I'm coming after you. I'm getting my plunger, gonna stick it on your face. I'll make you eat a urinal cake. I caught you masturbating in my bathroom stall. I caught you drawing pictures on my bathroom wall. You little kid, you think I don't remember the time I caught you peeing in my soap dispenser? I'm not telling your teacher, I'm not telling your dad. Just gonna beat you with my belt till it hurts real bad. About 3 years now, cause they won't let me hang out in the teacher's lounge. All I wanted was some goddamn coffee. Librarian, she can't keep her hands off me. I know she won't be able to ever forget the way I work my mop and get her floor wet. When I go in her room, check on her trash, I always sneak a peek and check out her ass. Now I keep a six pack in my janitor's closet. Sometimes I get so drunk I get sick and vomit. If the principal walks by and asks whose it is, I just lie and blame it on one of the kids. I'm gonna quit my job probably tomorrow, cause all I ever get is pain and sorrow. Miss Johnson, I'll miss you, I'll remember the day I fucked you in my Chevy Nova on my lunch break.
We're here to learn about floorball. It's a game I heard about online, and I guess it's turning into a huge worldwide event. Luckily, I have an inside scoop on the Columbia branch. Go ahead and follow me. We'll be right back.
he cool?
Look, Mr. Cognito, this is the fucking puppet show. What's going on here?
I've come here to play formal!
Did you come to the right place?
We don't fucking need the Centralia teams here in practice. I'm here to play. I think I'll fit in actually quite wonderful here.
Well, we've got 3 weeks till Nationals, so you're gonna need to fit in pretty well.
I'm cool, guys. I'm cool.
Yeah, let's see how cool.
I'm cool.
Hi, I'm the girl. I've been playing four ball with these guys for about 12 years now, I think. No, about 11. It's sort of hard sometimes, because, you know, there's not very many females in our sport. Technically, by regulation, we weren't even allowed until, like, 94. I've been playing a little bit on the underground circuit before that, but, you know, there's just not that many female players. It can be a trial sometimes. I mean, obviously the thrust, which is a major four ball move, it just, you know, it's different. It's different for us women. I enjoy it, but, you know, sometimes, you know, the guys get on my nerves.
Four ball. It's a game I know little about, but I'm getting ready to find out. And I think things are going to go well. I mean, these guys seem like they're just, you know, one of my own. But, just wait and see. You know, I have a feeling this sport is going to be, you know, it's going to be very becoming on me. Okay? One.
The game actually was known in its original form as forkball. And it was a Viking game, and they played it with an elk testicle. And it gained popularity throughout Europe in the 1200s, and finally made its way to the New World in 1984, during the Olympics in Los Angeles.
Harvey's a crazy lady all over.
First degree!
As I understand it, I believe floorball was developed, I believe it was the Inuits in the 9th century. But what they actually used was a dehydrated kidney of a husky. And the game was used as a means to establish the hierarchy amongst the warriors. He who was able to bounce the dehydrated kidney longer than anyone else was declared to be the most virile member of the clan, and all of the other members who were playing in the tournament would end up having to build his igloo. And it was a very manly game. Back then, from what I understand, he who was essentially lowest on the hierarchical chart of four ball players was essentially banished.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was four ball. I hope you enjoyed. I know I did.
What do you mean that's it?
That's it, right? I had a great time, and I feel like four ball is a sport that can be played by anyone in any third world country.
We got Lebanon Mo in 2 weeks, man. It's not over. It's never over.
It's a lot of work to be done. A lot of work.
But, all right, four ball. That was Blacksmith. If you'd like to know more about Blacksmith, you can check out their website,
at www.myspace/imblacksmith.
You can also write them an email at blacktonsmith@yahoo.com. Well, that about does it for us tonight. We're going to end you with some bloopers that we've accumulated while making this show over the last 6 years. So, if you think your band would make a good addition to Das Karnival, please send us an email at daskarnival@excite.com. As always, I'm Ian, and you're Columbia. Good night.
One.
Hello.
Here in Columbia, Missouri. It was made as part of the 48-hour film project, and it was made by a local... Fuck, what am I talking about?
Axial.
Damn. But I do know what this is. This is a film by local makers, makers of films, maker locals.
I don't want to hit you too hard.
But make it look real. All just right. Skim across the end. Well, they sure don't really look like rappers, do they?
Cut.
Oh, man. You all right?
Yeah.
I broke a smile. I didn't mean to do that.
Ah! I got a Charlie horse.
You okay?
Yeah, yeah.
Your mustache fell off.
You sure don't look like rappers, do they? They sure don't look like rappers. They sure don't look like rappers, do they?
You okay?
Yeah. That's perfect.
I had to hit you too hard, did I?
No, that's just right. Go ahead and hit that red button on the back.
Yeah, we rap.
They sure don't look like rappers, do they?
You guys really don't look like much rappers to me. Alright, let me try it again.
A smile, yeah. Bitch.
Before you do that, what CD is in your car right now?
Blacksmith. Car?
Alright, tonight's final question. What was the question again? A little more. And we're back! That was incredible. I mean, seriously, 10 to 27, amazing. You know what else is incredible? Is your breath, Hugo. I mean, wow, you're like 5 feet away. That's Hugo. He's our stage boy. He's also a fluffer.
Action. All right, now, Brandon.
No.